What's up, fellow YouTubers? I want to give a shout out to Kurt. His older brother was the one that sent me a badass apron and a bag of Carolina Reaper jerky, which he saw me eating on camera, dunking that bad boy in some horseradish and just being like, "Arr," you know what I'm saying? Yeah. In fact, I'm gonna give both of them a shout out. Read you this awesome fan letter he sent with the badass apron, which you'll see in my next cooking video. "Dear Cobes, I just wanted to send this care package as a thanks for all the hard work you do on YouTube. Sometimes I feel like I'm the only one who is sick of society shit. But whenever I go to your channel, I'm glad that you and the Cobra Cult can keep it real like me. I have been a longtime fan and have enjoyed watching your videos, especially the outdoor vlogs and the cooking videos. Maybe you can make a dank cooking video using the jerky and the badass cooking apron I sent." I'm definitely gonna be wearing that for cooking videos, yeah. "Anyways, thanks for telling it like it is on YouTube and not letting society tell you how to live. Love, Drew. P.S. Could you cast a circle of protection around my little brother, Kurt? He's been getting bullied in school because he's goth and practices magic like you. I know you can't use your powers for everyone, but it would mean a lot to me and him if you could cast one around him." Yeah, definitely. That's definitely a circle of protection for Kurt against the bullies, who is Drew's older brother, someone to be in the witch's circle. I kind of know how Kurt feels, honestly, because people who practice magic are always persecuted to some degree or shape or form. People who practice magic have been persecuted for centuries. Although we no longer see witches being burned at the stake or, you know, being hanged at the gallows and such, that doesn't mean that the persecution has stopped. Because now, even when I walk around town practicing my magic freely, people will fuck with me. And it's like, okay, I'm out here, excuse me, I'm out here minding my own business, practicing my belief peacefully and freely, and you give me shit for it. And the thing that I would tell Kurt, honestly, more than anything, the reason why they bully you for practicing magic is because you're secure in your own belief. Most of the kids your age don't have a belief, and that's why they feel insecure around you. Instead of just admitting that they feel insecure, they project their insecurities by bullying you because in their eyes, you're different. And, you know, one of the commandments of my religion is basically don't bully someone unless they bully you. Yeah. The Cobra's commandments, I like the sound of that. Thou shalt not rape, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not rape, thou shalt not steal or cheat. If you look at the Satanic Bible, for instance, the Satanic Bible has its own Ten Commandments, and they're pretty similar to the Christian's Ten Commandments. That's something to think about. In fact, for the sake of this here video, let's look it up, shall we? Hoo-hoo. The Satanic Bible's Ten Commandments. Alrighty. According to the Church of Satan, the 11 Satanic Rules of the Earth. 1. Do not give opinions or advice unless you are asked. Do not tell your troubles to others unless you are sure they want to hear them. When in another's lair, show him or her respect, or else do not go there. If a guest in your lair annoys you, treat him cruelly without mercy. Do not make sexual advances unless you are given the mating signal. Aha! Rule number 5 basically says, do not make sex unless it's consensual. Number 6 says, do not take that which does not belong to you unless it is a burden to the other person and he cries out to be relieved. 7 says, acknowledge the power of magic if you have employed it successfully to obtain your desires. If you deny the power of magic after having called upon it with success, you will lose all you have obtained. I especially agree with number 7. And number 8, do not complain about anything to which you need not subject yourself. And rule number 9, do not harm little children. 10, do not kill non-human animals unless you are attacked or for your food. This is the Church of Satan's website. And so far in these 11 rules, it says, don't harm little kids, don't rape, don't kill an animal unless you're eating it or it's attacking you. Rule number 11, when walking in open territory, bother no one. If someone bothers you, ask him to stop. If he does not stop, destroy him. That's great. I mean, I kind of get where it says, let's see. Do not give opinions or advice unless you are asked. Oh, I kind of get that. I mean, as far as the advice part goes, you know, but everyone's entitled to a free opinion to some degree, yeah? So, it's called the 11 Satanic Rules, so to speak. Yeah. And if you don't believe me, I'll put a link to this in the description box below with all of my usual links. You can check it out for yourself. Also, Ouija boards are not satanic. That is a common misconception. That is a very common misconception. Ouija boards are not satanic. They're not. But like, sincerely, people who are so quick to criticize Satan and Satanism as a whole, like, why don't you try reading the 11 satanic rules and then, you know. That's good pipe tobacco. So all these sick assholes who are, you know what I'm saying? A lot of what you see of Satanism is all the negative crap that you see people do. And this is why if Satan type people sacrifice animals, it's usually a chicken because they'll eat it afterwards. Because it's part of the 11 satanic rules, which basically states, do not kill an animal unless you're being attacked or it is your food. I especially agree with the one where it says, do not hurt little children. Oh yeah. As somebody who practices magic, it's important to do your research on other religions, you know, just to keep an open mind about things, you know, so when they start going at you about this and that, like when Christians tell me I'm going to hell because I practice magic, I'm like, thank you, and you're going to heaven, have a nice day. And they don't even know how to respond to that. They don't. They're just like, what? And a lot of these Christians, they talk about a war. Oh, like, oh my God, the Antichrist is coming. He's already here. He's already here. It's like, what war are you talking about? Like, it's fucking dumb, dude. Like, you talk about being a peace-loving religion, but then you talk about also having to fight a war? Like, okay. You want to give me shit for practicing magic, but Jesus Christ rose from the dead. That sounds like necromancy. Moses taking his staff and parting the Red Sea. That also sounds like magic. Behold, he took his staff and parted the Red Sea. Like, ooh, look at that. In fact, if you look at the so-called holy anointment oil, where they add cannabis, cinnamon, virgin olive oil, That's potion making. You want my honest opinion, YouTube? I think the Bible was misinterpreted. I think the Bible tells us to worship ourselves as gods and goddesses rather than to worship some unseen BS. The fact that the churches are against prostitution, yet Jesus Christ himself had sex with an of-age hooker, and she was old enough for the time's laws, it was consensual. You know, it's just like, wow, dude, okay. And Kurt, don't let those assholes get to you, man. You keep practicing magic as long as you're not hurting anyone, you're not hurting yourself, you're not hurting small children, you're not hurting animals. Then who cares, you know? Straight up. I very rarely use magic for self-gain. There are quite often, many a times, I'll use my magic to help other people. I've used my magic to help people before, and, you know, just watching it happen. Oh, yeah. I'm just saying, YouTube, before you go off judging Satan, how about you read the 11 satanic rules and then ask yourself, have I been told the truth or am I being brainwashed, you know? I'm just saying. Would I visit a satanic church? Oh, hell yeah, I would. Fuck yeah, I would. That'd be fun. You know, my advice to Kurt, honestly, is try to make friends who share the same interests and life will be a little bit easier, you know. You find people who practice magic like you do, you know. But like I said, don't let those assholes get to you, Kurt. It's not worth it, man. Anyways, YouTube. Thank you for watching the video. And I'll catch you cool cobras later.